a reversible EET engine operating between two temperatures. Between two temperatures known as Carnot engine. This is the principle. Okay, reversible heat engine operating between two temperatures known as Carnot engine. Okay, so now Carnot engine, now I am going to consider the ideal gas. So working substance. Okay, in the Carnot engine, how the Carnot engine is working? Okay, in the Carnot engine, now I am going to take that gas. Okay, which gas we can consider? That ideal gas we can consider. First, you have to write the definition. What is the definition? The reversible heat engine operating. What? Only one sentence you have to remember. Okay, it is operating between the two temperatures. Let us take temperature, we are denoting the T. Okay, two temperatures means, let us take T1 and T2. This you have to take. Okay, now the Carnot engine diagram is shown in the below figure. Okay, Carnot engine, what should substance should be there? Substance, the inside the Carnot engine, the gas should be there. So that now I am considering ideal gas is substance in the Carnot engine and the Carnot engine. So the Carnot engine diagram I shown in below. See, like this is the, this is x-axis, this is y-axis. Okay, on the y-axis you can consider V. Okay, next to plot this graph like this, V and P. X-axis you can consider V, on the y-axis you can consider the P. So here, now I am going to draw that. This point A, this point B, this point C, this point D. What I said, next P1, next V1, T1, next P2, V2, T2, sorry, T1, next P3, V3, T2, next P4, V3, T4. Okay, let us consider A point, B point, C point, D point. So at the A point, P1, V1, T1, next at the B point, B point, P2, V2, T1, next at the C point, P3, V3, T3, at the D point, P4, V4, T2, you have to consider. Okay, the process is from way to way it's going on. What is this process? Reversible process. Okay, direction should be must like this. Okay, this is about the direction. First, what is there? First one here, AB is there. Next, the one I am writing here. See, why? Because this is needed. First one is there, AB is there. Next, BC is there. Next, what is there? CD is there. Next, what is there? AD or DA is there. Okay, A to B, next B to C, next C to D, next D to A. Okay, what A to B, what we can call? So here A, this and this expansion, what we can call this is expansion, this is also expansion, AB. Next, isothermal expansion. What? Thank you. See, now we got the four process: A, B, next B, C, next C, D, next D, A. So first one, A, B. What is the A, B? Isothermal process. Next one, B, C. Adiabatic expansion. Next, C, D. Isothermal compression. Next, adiabatic compressions. Okay, here two are expansion. Next, compression. First, we'll see. What is the expansion and what is the compression? So you might have known about the compression means the suppose let us take if you consider elastic, okay, if you straight if you apply the both side force, what happens? It is extended, means what we can say, expansion. Length is increasing, means what we can say, if you apply the force, length is increasing, then we can say that is the expansion. Okay, if you apply, let us take the sponge duster, if you apply the both side forces, what happens? That is coming very near, then we can thought what we can say, that is the compressions. So here total how many processor will be existing? So four processor will be existing. So what is the first one? Isothermal expansion. Next one, adiabatic expansion. Next two, isothermal compression. Next one, adiabatic compression. Okay, see, first we have to find the how much energy done here. Okay, first one, okay, isothermal expansion, A, B. First one. Okay, isothermal expansion. See, the diagram is there. Isothermal expansion, what happened? Let us consider pressure P1, V1, pressure P1, volume V1, temperature T1. Then what happened? A to B, the process going expansion. Then what happened? Pressure P1 to P2, volume V1 to V2. Temperature is constant. Why? Isothermal expansion. What should be constant in this? Temperature should be constant. So then what we can write here? The work done is isothermal process. Okay, what we can write? So let us take W1 is equal to Q1. Okay, already we have done, we have derived this equation. Okay, W1 is equal to Q1 2.303 N or T1. Why? Because temperature is T1. So value what happened? V1 to V2. So we have taken the limits, isothermal expansion, isothermal process, we have done the work done system. So how much we got? W1 2.303 R T1 log V2 by V1. Next one, isothermal expansion over. Next, what is the second one? Adiabatic expansion.
In organization, also we play the role of
okay. Adiabatic expansion. Then what happened? Let us consider pressure P2 to P3, volume V2 to V3. Next, temperature T1 to T2. Then what happened? Then what we can write? Then work done in isothermal, sorry, adiabatic. This is the equation number one. This is the equation number two. Okay, next. First one over, next second one over. Next, what is the next curve? CD curve is there. AB curve, BC curve. Next, come to the CD curve. What is the CD curve? Isothermal compression. Okay, isothermal compression. In the isothermal compression, what is happening? See, where is the isothermal compression? Then C to D. So same thing happened here. What happened here? Pressure how much is there? P3 is there. Value how much is there? V3 is there. Temperature how much is there? T2 is there. So here how much is there? T2 only is there. So what happened? P4 is P4, P3 to P4. Next to V3 to V4. Same formula will come. Same again. W2 is equal to, next to Q2 is equal to 2.303 N R T2. Next log. What is there next one? What is coming here? V1, V2. Next? V4 by V3. This is the equation number 3. Work done. Okay, next. What is the next fourth one? Last one. Adiabatic compression. So adiabatic compression, what happened again? P1 to P4 to P1, next V4 to V1, T1, T2 to T1. Then work done on the system. What happened? Okay, we got the different expansion, AB curve, BC curve, CD curve, next DA curve. Okay, total work done. Double four. But here you will get in the next, here also you will get negative sign, here also you will get the negative sign. Why? Because that is the opposite direction. Okay, so this is equation number 5. Now substitute the equations. Total work we are going to do it. Find it. How much is there? So if you return W is equal to total how much energy, AB curve, BC curve and CD curve and DA curve. So here two terms are same thing, then gets cancelled. Then what is the work done? W is equal to. Okay, this is the work done in the Carnot engine. Okay, next, now I want the efficiency. Okay, here what is that equation in the, from the graph? V3 by V4. Okay, next, what I am going to find, next I am going to find about the efficiency. The efficiency, the total work by the how much it is given, then we can say that is the efficiency. Efficiency means how much efficiency are working. You are working 100% or 90% or 20%. So that efficiency means the working capability. Then we can say that is the efficiency. Okay, efficiency we are denoting the which letter here? Neta we are denoting. Neta. Okay, neta is equal to what is the formula? Then total work. Total work by Q1. So total work how much is there? 2.303 n RT1 log V2 by V1 minus 2.303 n RT2 log V3 by V4 by what is there next one? Q1 is there. Q1 how much is there? Already we are having. This is 2.303 n RT1 log V2 by V1. So if I separate them, this okay, if you separate what I mean, then these terms and those terms will be get cancelled. This is gets cancelled. Then what is remaining? This also gets cancelled. What is remaining? 1 minus T2 log V3 by V4. Next, T1 log V2 by V1. So this is which equal to neta equal to. Okay, next. Okay, next. According to adiabatic relation between the temperature and volume. Okay, according to adiabatic relation between volume and temperature, then what we can write? Okay, next, can I write here? T1, next, what is the first one? This is the equation number. How much we can take? This is the equation number. We can consider A. Next one, what we can write? V1, V4. Okay. Simply, what I am doing simply here, adiabatic expansion, we can. So what we need actually V2 by V1 or V3 by V4 we need. Simply if you do the equation 1 divided by 2, what happened then? V2 by V1 then gamma A divided by 2 also you can do. That is your choice. Then what happened? V3 by V4 is equal to gamma minus 1. Here also gamma minus 1. So finally what you are getting? V2 by C. Or else you can send this side. Then we can remove. V2 by V1 is equal to V3 by V4. Okay, next what we can write? V1. So V3 by V4 is equal to what we can write? See here. So what we are having here? V3 by V4 we are having. So here also we are having. Simply I am writing here. Neta is equal to 1 minus T2 log V3 by V1. Since V3 by V4 is equal to V2 by V1. V2 by V1 by next what is there here theta 1 sorry T1 log V2 by V1. So what happened? What happened in this case? Neta is equal to 1 minus this is not W actually this is neta. Neta what happened? This log V2 by V1 next log V2 by V1 both gets cancelled then T2 is remaining here. T2 divided by T1. So here neta is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. Okay, this is your formula for Carnot cycle. Okay, this is the finding the formula for Carnot. Your Carnot engine is how much efficiency it is working. Based on this principle, we can say, okay, this is the final formula. Efficiency we are denoting neta. Neta is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1, where T1 temperature Kelvin, T2 also Kelvin. Neta is the efficiency. In general, we are taking the efficiency percentage. Neta is equal to 10%, 20%, like that we can say. Okay, finally, you will get in the exam. Explain about the reversible process and irreversible process. Then you have to derive the equation for Carnot engine. For that you have to consider the graph. Next AB curve, BC curve, CD curve, DA curve. Then you can get the answer. Neta is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1.